In this video, we will see the definition of what is a topology that is essential to understand everything we have. And after understanding the definition, we will work on a few examples that will make things a bit clearer. So let's see the definition. We say that a topology on a set X is a collection tau of subsets of X. So this tells us that tau is a subset of parts of X that has the following properties. The empty set and X are in the topology. The union of the elements of any subcollection of tau is in tau. And here what's important is this word any. So we're not talking about any specific cardinality. We're not saying the union of finite elements or countable. So we're saying any subcollection that is countable, uncountable, we don't care. Any union of elements of tau is in tau. And the last property, now we do have one of these restrictions, is that the intersections of the elements of any finite subcollection of tau is in tau. So basically, we have the empty set and the whole set are in the topology. We have arbitrary unions of sets, and we have finite intersections. So we say that X with the topology T is going to be a topological space. In some books, you or even myself, we say that the pair X tau is a topological space, and sometimes when it's not necessary to specify the topology, we will just say X is a topological space. And when we say that, it's implied that we have a set tau. So it's not just the set X, it's actually this that we're talking about. So this definition seems a bit abstract, so let's actually work on a few examples. So if I'm given some set X, I can think immediately of two topologies. The first one is the trivial topology. And this topology is defined as just the empty set and the whole set. So it is obvious that it satisfies property number one, but then the union of any subcollection of elements in the topology, the only union I could get is X union the empty set, and that is X. So it's again in the topology, so it satisfies the second property. And then the intersection of elements, if I intersect the empty set with X, then I get the empty set. And again, the empty set is in the topology, so it's trivially satisfying all three properties. So this is a topology, it's called trivial, or sometimes you can find it as the indiscrete topology. The other topology that we can think about immediately is the discrete topology. And this one is defined simply as parts of X. And again, it's obvious that this topology satisfies the properties because parts of X is the collection of every subset of X. And so obviously the union of an arbitrary collection of sets is also a subset of X. And so it will be in parts of X, and the same with finite intersections. But now let's see a bit more complicated ones, because these ones, well, they were too trivial. So what happens if my set X, for example, is A, B, C, just three elements. And a good idea here is to draw bags to actually represent the topology. So we can immediately have the trivial and the discrete topology, which will be just selecting all these and, well, the empty set in here. I'm not even gonna draw the empty set. We also have the discrete topology. So one bag is grabbing all the sets. Then you have the bag that's grabbing each of the sets individually, of the elements, I'm sorry. Then the bag that's grabbing them two by two. And I think that is everything. Obviously, again, the bag that just grabs nothing, the empty set. But we can continue. There are more topologies to define in this set. We will always have the bag that's grabbing all of them. So what happens if I grab just this element, and then on another set, these two? Well, let's write what this topology actually is, so that it makes sense for us to try and prove that it is a topology. Well, again, we have the empty set and the whole set. We have the set A and the set B, C. This one is the yellow one, and this other one is the green. So if I grab the intersection of any two sets, well, these two won't play bigger roles, but what happens, for example, with A union BC? Well, this is ABC, and ABC is our set, so we can find that element in the topology over there. And the intersection? Well, if I take A intersection BC, this intersection is empty. And so, again, we can find the empty set in there. So we have unions, we have the intersections, and we have X and the empty set. This set is a topology. We can go even further and try to complicate things a bit. Now we can grab the set A, the set B, and the set AB. Well, this, again, is a topology. Let's see what it is. We have the empty set, the whole set, then A and B separately, and then finally A and B together in the green bag. So again, let me add the colors. And here you might be saying, hey, but you never mentioned C. So C is not in the topology as a singleton, and it's not part of this other set, it's just here in X. So that doesn't affect us? Well, it doesn't actually, because when we try, for example, the union, so A union B is giving us AB, which is that element. The intersection of these two is empty, but the intersection of, for example, A with AB, this is A, and it's a part of our topology, and the same with B. So no, it doesn't affect us that we are not considering that singleton. So you can see that topologies can be very big. We can have something very complicated like this. Or we can have very simple things like just the whole set and the empty set, just a few sets, and we can even totally ignore one of those elements, and the set can still be a topology. But then, last video, I told you that in topology, we're going to define things like closed sets and compactedness and so on. Well, it seems very odd that from something like this, we can get to such complicated results. But believe me, we will get there. And to prove you this, let's continue with some a bit more complicated examples on sets that are not just three elements. There are still a lot of topologies in this set, so I recommend you, if you want to spend some time fighting with this, try and find a few more examples of topology. So the next topology, if we have some set X, it's called the finite complement topology, and it's defined like this. We call it T sub F of finite, and it's going to be the set of all these subsets of X such that either X minus U, so the complement of U, is finite, or X minus U is equal to X. This set is a topology. Let's go ahead and prove it. Remember what we have to prove. The first one is that the empty set and the whole set are in the topology. So let's do that one first. Well, X minus X is the empty set. And the empty set, it is finite, trivially. So this tells us, you see, U is in the topology if X minus U is finite. And so this tells us that X here will be playing the role of U is in the topology. Also, x minus the empty set is just x. So now we are in this second part here, because we don't know if our set is finite or not. Maybe x minus the empty set is not finite. I mean, if x is the set of the real numbers, for example, then the real numbers minus the empty set is the real numbers, but that's not a finite set. No, doesn't matter, because we're considering that case here, and so we have that the empty set is in the topology. Sorry, I just spot that error here in the topology. Let's see the second thing we have to prove. It's the union of elements of any subcollection of the topology is in the topology. So we need to grab any subcollection of the topology and prove that the union is in there. For that, so the union has to be arbitrary. And to denote arbitrary unions, what it's done usually is using a subindex alpha. So I'm just gonna say, okay, let U alpha, for alpha, just some index moving in any set, countable, uncountable, doesn't matter, be a collection of elements in the topology. So what we want to prove is that the union of all these sets are also in the topology. This is what we want to prove. Well, how do we do this? Well, we have here the definition of the topology. So if we want to see whether a set U is in the topology or not, we have to see if one of these two things are satisfied. So we have to calculate X minus U. Now I want to see if this union is in the topology, and so I will have to do X minus the union. X minus the union over alpha of all these sets. And now we have the complement of a union. Using the Morgan's law, we get the intersection of the complements, so X minus U alpha. But U alpha are all elements in the topology. So this tells us that each of these is finite, or the whole set X, because that is in the definition of our topology. So we have an arbitrary intersection of finite sets, or X. So if one of these complements is finite, then the intersection will be finite. If they are all X, then the intersection will be all X. And so this tells us that this intersection is finite, or X. It will be X in the case where every U alpha was the empty set. And so from this, what we have is that this set, the union of all the elements in our collection, is in the topology. And that is exactly what we wanted to prove. Now, let's see property number three. The intersection of elements of any finite subcollection of this topology is in the topology. Well, let's take a finite collection of elements in the topology and prove that their intersection is also there. Let's take U1 up to UN, elements in our topology, and again, we want to prove that the intersection from I equals 1 up to N of all these sets, we want to prove that all this is in the topology. Again, how do we do that? With the definition, we have to prove that X minus that intersection is either finite or is all X. So let's calculate this complement. X minus the intersection of these sets. Again, we have the complement of an intersection. So using the Morgan's law, that is the union from I equals 1 up to N of the complements. And as before, because each of these is in the topology, these things are either finite or the whole set. So the union, this is a finite union of finite things, or x, if one of them is x, so if at least one use of I is the empty set, then the union will be the whole set. But if all of them are finite, then the finite union will be finite. So this is finite or x. It will be x, as I said, when at least one of the use of I's is the empty set. And so, like before, we have that this intersection is in our topology. And with this, we have completed proving the three things. So we can now say that TF is a topology. Before we finish this video, there are a few small definitions that might be useful for you to know. We were able to understand what a topology is. Now, the elements in the topology, the elements in tau, so when we have some set U in tau, we say that U is an open set. The reason why we call them open set will be clear for us later on in the reproduction list. And finally, what happens when we have two topologies on a set? For example, what we have here. Here for this set A, B, and C, we have many topologies. Well, let's define a few things. So let's say we have a set X and two topologies, tau and tau prime, such that tau is a subset of tau prime. So that is, every open set in the tau topology is also an open set in tau prime topology. Well, then what we say is that tau prime is finer than tau. Or we also say that tau is coarser than tau prime. For example, tau can be the trivial topology, and tau prime can be the topology of parts of X. Then parts of X is finer than tau. But if we go to our examples, we have these two topologies. If we call this one tau and this one tau prime, then we have none of those inclusions. I mean, tau is not a subset of tau prime. And also tau prime is not a subset of tau. Well, this is because these two topologies are not comparable. So we say that tau and tau prime are comparable if one of those things is satisfied. Tau is subset of tau prime, or tau prime is a subset of tau. With this, we finish this video. Remember that if you want to buy Moncrest, I'm leaving a link in the description of the video for you to buy it and simultaneously support the channel. If you also want to support the channel, we have Patreon, and we have actually just released a 7-day free trial of Patreon. The link is also in the description.